Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to Houghton Kirby and this, the 21st Wrestlers Reunion here in the South. A big cheer. 21 years we've been doing this.
It is.
It's lovely to see you all. We thought that we wouldn't have much of a turnout because of the Olympics, and we can't compete with them, of course.
Oh, God.
Well, we can because you're here. But some of the big wrestlers who live abroad couldn't get here. They've sent their apologies and asked that you all have a great time in their absence. The worst one is Mark Rollerball Rocco. He had bought his tickets finally, and they've had a bushfire on the mountain where he lives, and they've evacuated all the homes, his included. So he's hotter than we are. Jimmy Brakes was coming over but couldn't get a return tomorrow. Again, he sends his apologies. And Tony Sinclair's grandson, of course, was going to be considered for the Olympics, and he waited till the last minute and couldn't get a connection. So, sincerest apology from those three revered gentlemen. Before we start anything, ladies and gentlemen, I want to say thank you. Because for the last 18 years of this reunion, our hosts have been two lovely people who never asked for any credit or any money. Well, perhaps money. And I know you're all regulars, most of you, but there are people here that are new to us. There are supporters that really don't know anybody. And the difficulty is that over the years we all age and change. And sometimes people come here and then say, well, no one spoke to me. I've been in the business years. And they forget that they've altered a bit. So please don't be frightened to go and speak to each other and introduce yourselves like you do. Because we are a fraternity of friendship. But for today, I would like you please to say thank you to Miss Great Britain, the biggest female bodybuilder in the world. You can't miss her. The one and only Sarah Bridges. Yay! For the food, the preparation, and the money she spends on it. And of course, also to my dearest friend here of the last 53 years. He is the former 3 times heavyweight champion of the world to the supporters, the one and only Mr. Wayne Bridges. For those of you who don't know, Wayne, or Bill as he likes to be called, his real name, suffered a very severe spinal injury and had to have a 7-hour operation. And the surgeons cut through the nerves in his back by accident, and he's struggling to walk up straight, but he does it without any complaint, and he has to wait several years, if we've got them, for those nerves to re-knit. So I think his courage in standing here every year and going through it is fantastic. Yeah. My friend Wayne Bridges. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Don't fuss him too much. Now the sad bit that we always do, the 10-bell count, in memory of those dear departed gladiators that have left us. And introducing you, as we always do, in tradition, one of the greatest legends of wrestling ever, one of the great stars. Here he is, the one and only Mr. Colin Joynson. And he can't get on the box, of course, because...
Can you imagine all the bumps I used to take in and out of the ring? I can't climb on the bloody box.
Yeah, I'm now on me own. You've nicked my stick. How dare you?
We're not going to fall over this year.
Just before I put you on to Colin, I've missed one apology. Mick McManus. He always opens a reunion. He's 93 years old and he's extremely ill. And his wife Barbara phoned Bill a couple of days ago, said he's heartbroken, he can't be here again. But he really, really is not well, and we are a little worried for him, but he does hope to be back on his feet soon. So mixed apologies, ladies and gentlemen. Right, Colin Joynson.
Thank you. Well, it comes that time again that I have to stand here in front of each and every one of us and talk about people that have passed away and gone and not with us anymore. So I'm going to do the very best I can now. Get rid of this walking stick so I don't wobble and fall over.
Stop nicking it.
Early on this year, a northern wrestler called Joe Keegan passed away. And just a couple of months later, his brother Jack passed away. Both fantastic wrestlers, good workers, and they will be sadly missed. after them, there was a guy called Tony Wood, who I don't know so well, so the Viking, not much I can say. One that I can say about, but best I didn't, Jimmy Savile, he passed away. Then we had a lady wrestler called Tracy Kemp. But the one that means so much to me, and he meant so much to me in my time in the business, and there was none better, Jumping Jimmy Hussey,
father
to Mark Rocco. There was none better, and the man was wrestling personified. Also, Dave Butcher Bond. Who'd have thought that Dave Bond would have lost Dave last year? He was only 57, and he was in the gym when it happened. What a nice guy Dave was. We had a wrestler called Ray Diamond, the White Angel, which I didn't know. Lisa Loren, not really.
Jack Cassidy's daughter.
Harry Cohegan. Judo Alf Marquette. If you all remember Judo Alf Marquette, he used to wear the white trouser suit and everything.
He's been here.
He used to come regular down here, but Alf passed away last year. Lex Valentine. And then, on the 1st of May this year, a guy who was my tag partner for a few years. I took him up north to live up back in Stockport, Steve Haggerty. Steve Haggerty passed away. David Hines. I didn't know David Hines. But then, the one and only, a guy I saw when I was only 16, I went to Bellevue to the King's Hall to watch the wrestling. And I watched this fella with a match with Melvin Riss. And it was the best match I've ever seen in my life. The man could shoot and he could do the job. He went to Australia. The one and only Bernard Murray. Bernard died. And last but no means least, and his funeral I went to only the other week. He didn't do so much down Dales, but he spent a lot around the north. The one and only Alf Cadman. So, gentlemen, will you all bear with me now for a minute's silence and a 10-bell count? Thank you very much. One final thing before I go. If there is a life hereafter, they've got one hell of a bill up there, haven't they? Hey? There's nothing down here can compare with what was gone and left us on our own. And the other thing I'd like to say, personally, hiya Sean. Great to see you. Thank you very much.
The wonderful Colin Johnson, ladies and gentlemen. Always upbeat, always happy. Great, great grafter. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the time where we say thank you to certain people in the wrestling business and at the side of it. They're not necessarily the big mega stars, although God knows we get enough of those here, and we've thanked nearly all of them in our time. But nevertheless, there's always deserving people. And even if you haven't heard of them necessarily, please take our word that they have done something in contribution to the reunion and the wrestling business. So the very first award today, we should have done a long time ago and we actually forgot. Sorry about that. And for that, I want to call up one of the greatest technical wrestlers around today. Absolutely fantastic, Mr. Johnny Kidd. Now, Now, John's going to present an award to one of his great friends, so I'm going to leave him to actually speak about him. Thank you very much. Johnny Kidd.
Thank you, Frank, Bill, and everybody here. This award, like Frank says, is very long overdue. The person I'm going to give the award to started around the same time as I did. I met him first in 1975 when we used to train in Northamptonshire. We started out together for Dale Martin's early in 78. Ken Joyce brought me into wrestling. He also helped this fellow in as well. We wrestled all over the South with some of the best names that were around then. McManus Logan, Bobby Barnes, Stevie Gray, Mal Sanders, all these sort of people. Johnny Saint even when I saw him when John was down here. He's done a lot for wrestling. He never complained about anything we ever did. He went on to other things when we went our separate ways. He tagged with the famous Kendo Nagasaki for 5 years, I believe, against much heavier men, Rocco Jones, Haystacks, people like that. Again, never complained. Good worker in his own right, and I think this award is well deserved. So, wherever you are, Bob, Blondie Bob Barrett, will you please come forward? Thank you.
Wherever you like.
Bob, on behalf of the British Wrestlers Reunion, on this 21st anniversary, I'd like to present it to you this award. It's you and Kendo on here, I see. And well done for everything you've done. So I've known you a long time, and it is very, very long overdue. Do you want to say a few words?
Not really, I don't know what to say to this. I'll do my best. I'll try. Right, thanks very much, everybody. Yeah, I'm doing my best here. I'm not used to all this sort of talking and all that, so just want to say thank you. Marvellous. Good Mel there.
The great Blondie Barrett, ladies and gentlemen. Very modest wrestler, but what a great, great grappler. Thank you. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, goes equally to another grafter of the same size, same stature, done exactly the same in the business. And to present it, I'm going to ask one of, again, the big legends of wrestling over the last 30 years to step up here if he's around. Can I have the one and only Mal Sanders, please? Come on, Mal. Thank you. You could present the award too.
No, I don't. All right, okay. This has all been just thrown on me. I'm no good with a mic, as everybody will tell you. Jimmy Ocean should be up here with me. This goes to someone who's been in the business, like Bob Barrett, for years and years, and had no recognition, and, you know, was just sort of turned up with his bag and wrestled, and, you know, not asked for any, not wages, but not asked for any fame. Not like this fella in the front row. He won 2 gold medals yesterday, Jack.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be going. What for, Jack, were they?
I'm not telling you.
He's not telling me.
One was for tripping over.
The two-time of the first medal. So this award, if he's around, all I can see is Lex Pollard's beard glistening in the wind. But this award is for Barry Cooper. Where are you, Bal?
Barry!
Yes. There you are, Bal. And it's not what you thought it was for. Yeah. It's for services to wrestling. Give him a big hand, everybody, for Barry. Well, tell him about. Tell him what you just said.
Oh, I'm never, ever, ever, ever
coming here again.
The wonderful Barry Cooper and Mal Sanders, ladies and gentlemen. Give him a big hand. Thank you. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask a real legend to get up here. It's wonderful to see him back with us today. A few short months ago, he had 3 heart attacks in a week. We thought we'd lost him. He's had a triple bypass. He's back in the gym training. And if he's here, I hope I can't see him.
He's here.
Let's please welcome the one and only Bob Kirkwood.
Oh, come on, Bob.
Come up here, you. You can get up now. You've got new heart.
Yeah, I've got new knees.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask Bob to present an award to a wrestler of yesteryear who always supports the reunion, puts money in it, comes up here, never says a word. You won't know him particularly nowadays, but he's a great, great grappler, Jim Howard.
He's a ward when she gives it to you.
Oh, right.
Come on, muck up, Bob. Nice.
Where's Jim Howard?
Yeah, we only want you up there.
Jim Howard.
That's what they all say. Lovely. Jump up there, Jim.
Oh,
Jim Howard.
That's
very nice, isn't it?
Oh, that's lovely. What a lovely award, eh? Better than the one I got. Yeah.
Better work.
I was going to say that.
Better work. Right, congratulations, Jim.
Thank you very much.
This is your award. Do you want to say a few words to the public?
Yeah, just a few words. Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I am truly shocked and honoured, and it's absolutely fantastic to come here every year, to be part of this is just absolutely fabulous. And I know people come from all over the country, and in fact, in some cases, all over Europe. Thank you so much to all those people who make that effort year after year. Thank you very much, everyone.
Well done, Jim.
Jim Howard, ladies and gentlemen, and the one and only Bob Kirkwood back on his feet. Wonderful to see you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's the ladies' turn. I can see her. You can't miss her from here. To introduce the next award, I'm going to ask another great legend of wrestling, great favourite of the reunion, a raconteur. He does speaking for his living now. He's the man who appeared against Big Daddy 700 times at least. The former tag partner of the great Giant Haystacks.
Never won once.
Let's
never
have it. Yeah, never won a belt since.
Never won once.
Warren. One and only, Banger Walsh.
God, so.
Yeah, we'll
do that in a minute, yeah?
All right.
We've got Rigby's here.
Well, I was hoping my friend, part of the Leamington Mafia, as you know, me, Turpin, the late Chris Adams, we used to terrorise people all over the country. That was just in service stations. But this award is for my friend Ringo Rigby, Les Utspeth, member of the British judo team. And if I could just take this minute for you all to just have a little minute for Chris Adams. Chris was one of my best friends. I taught him to wrestle on the lawn at my house. And as the lads are saying, Banger couldn't teach anybody to wrestle. But Chris, unfortunately, was murdered. He went to America and he worked in with the Southern States in Dallas, and he was it kicked off and he was killed. But he was our friend. And just spare him half a minute for him, will you? Chris Judo Adams, please. I say, I'll give Ringo this. He lives across from me, but he's in the cheap houses. Right, we've got to do another one, have I? Right. Oh, well, I'm happy to do this, actually, because I know she's a friend of my boys. If you don't know, my son Darren, Thunder as he works as, he's in Germany most of the time working at the moment, but I've just been told by him this week he's going to do a few shows for Brian Dixon, so you might see him coming back into this country. But this award is for a lady who is really doing a lot at the moment to lift wrestling, which I hope to think we did with the thing with me, Mick McManus and Rocco, where we did the Time of Their Lives, and I think that lifted the interest back up. But it gives me such great pleasure to present this, because I've known this lady a long, long time. I know her old man, and we've crossed because Darren used to work for him. This award is for services to wrestling. It's for Julia Hamer, Sweet Soraya. I hope you all watched the telly of the week. Me and Darren sat and watched it together. And
did you cry? Cross,
no, we laughed our heads off.
Oh, jump up, kid.
Come on.
Oh, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, a well-deserved award.
That's pretty cool.
Well, Rick said if I didn't say nice things, you're going to whack me.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Sweet Soraya.
Oh. You want me to talk?
Yeah, go on.
Wow, thank you. I've never heard anything like this before, and
I didn't actually think I ever would, but I really appreciate this. It's pretty awesome. And it's just topping off something for the Knight family that's just been actually a real amazing year, what with, you know, all the heat and everything we're getting at the minute, and it just seems to be getting better. And this will definitely be in my office, and my God, I really appreciate this. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Back to you, Frank.
The lovely, sweet Soraya, ladies and gentlemen, Julia Hamer, and of course the one and only Banger Walsh. Thank you, Banger. The Knight Dynasty gets bigger and bigger, ladies and gentlemen. There's a whole family of them. We haven't forgotten the others, but we'll go down them. And of course, with the recent television coverage and their own reality show, they've ended up more famous than any of them. So well done them. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, are two dear friends of mine. I'm very pleased about that. And to present the award, I'm going to ask yet another legend to get up on the podium, if he would. Don't look at the floor. It's the one and only pretty boy himself, Mel Stewart. He thought I would ignore him. Come on, Mel. The steps around the back. Oh. And he will tell you all about who's getting the award. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The award that I'm going to award today is to a very good friend of mine. We're always talking nearly every day on Skype. My wife always calls us the old grump, is like, you know, because we always moan him. Anyhow, the award is for Tony White. As I say, he's a very good friend of mine, and Tony and I go back many, many, many years. We've travelled together over the years in wrestling, like most of the boys have. The award is for Tony White. Oh, yeah. He did have a nickname, Titch White, but I always failed to see why they said that, because this man, for his size, always had a good body.
Thank you, Frank.
Hello, Tony.
Thank you, Mel.
Well, Tony, on behalf of myself and obviously the wrestling fraternity and the British Wrestlers Reunion, right, and a well-deserved award. And by the way, Tony, by the end of next week, will be going down to live in Spain with his lovely wife, and so we want to wish him all the best of his new life in Spain, right, you know. And so this has just come right for Tony. He can hang it in his wherever, down in his home. And that's a lovely photograph of you there, Tony.
So when
he has his guests come round and he's got this in a place, I hope like mine, it's people see it. You know, so they could say, well, hang on, this fella's done quite well in his life. So anyhow, Tony, on behalf of myself and the British Wrestling Reunion, you're a water.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I feel very humbled, almost embarrassed, to accept this award in such from the company of such talented people. But I shall accept it, and thank you very much, Mel. Thank you.
Titch White, ladies and gentlemen, Tony White, and the one and only Mel Stewart. Thank you. And good luck in Spain, Tony.
Thank you.
Hope it rains every day. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, we don't normally do posthumous awards because there's over 200 legends all dead, and we would never get through them. But sometimes the families contact us and they come here to share the day with us. So we feel it very respectful to offer an award in memory of their dead loved ones. And the next award is in that vein. In fact, we've got two or three here today. And to present the award, I'm going to ask again one of the great, great legends of wrestling world, Mr. Roy St. Clair, to step up here and make the award. And he's going to make it to the daughter of the late, great Frankie Hughes.
Oh, yeah.
Miss Jill Drake. So I'll ask Roy first, please, to come up and make the award for us.
At least he can get
on
there.
Jill Drake.
Of course he can get on there. Didn't expect this. But it's nice to see everybody anyway, and a few faces I haven't seen for quite a few years. And some very, very good friends. I remember Frankie Hughes coming up to Manchester and I took him in the nightclubs. And I think that's when he started getting into trouble.
Why not?
It wouldn't be you, Sinclair.
Oh, no.
Yeah, he was quite a good friend. I remember him when I first started for Dale Martins. He was one of the first men that I ever wrestled down in the South. So, all we need now is Frankie's daughter.
Is she here?
Yep.
Here she is.
Two of us.
Ladies and gentlemen, these are the two daughters of the late great Frankie Hughes. Sorry, we couldn't find them temporarily. Thank you, Jill.
Okay, my dad would be so proud today, as we are. He's been gone 10 years now, bless him. He would be over the moon with this, so thank you very much. But I do want to say, before I take this, my mum put up with a lot. So this is for my mum too, so thanks, guys. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the two daughters of Frankie Hughes and the wonderful Roy St. Clair. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm almost frightened to share a podium with the next man. This bugger, the best looking man in wrestling that ever lived, became a film star. They said, with your looks, you should be a legend in Hollywood. So he went to the movies, and the first film they gave him, Planet of the Apes. And they stuck a monkey suit on him. Ladies and gentlemen, this man is so good looking, I'm so fed up, and told him next year, stay in the car park, because it's the one, the only, one of the biggest legends ever lived, the Dazzler, Joe Cornelius. I'm so proud to have him here, ladies and gentlemen. 84, 5 years old, still trains in the gym 3 days a week, the one and only Joe Cornelius, who will present a prize to one of the great heavyweights of the early 60s. Joe, I expect you wouldn't want to get up here, will you? You stand there. Thank you.
Stay on the ground, Joe.
They used to call me the Dazzler, but I've dimmed a bit. Anyway, who am I giving this to?
Alan Kitto.
Alan who?
Kitto.
Kitto. Alan Kitto, come up and help me. Where is he?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, he was a great heavyweight star. It's a Life Achievement Award, early 60s and the late 50s. Here he comes, 80 years old, still looks bloody fit. The one and only Alan Kitto.
Right, Alan, a lifetime achievement. Got your name down there and the picture. Is that a picture of you?
It is.
Good looking bastard, weren't you? Yeah. Anyway, it's great to give you this. I've got to tell you, I did get one of these things, but it wasn't so beautiful as this, the way they've done it out. Gorgeous, yeah. I'll get them to do me another one. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much,
indeed. God bless.
Thank you. But it's nice to be here and see all my friends. But today was special. Today I met a friend of mine from 40 years ago, Freddie Bentley. Hello, Fred. Do you remember Freddie, anyone? Should have done. Thank you.
You did indeed. You did. Alan Kitto, ladies and gentlemen, still as fit as a fiddle. And thanks to the one and only Dazzler himself, Mr. Joe Cornelius. They don't make legends like that these days. Now we're going to thank, not a wrestler, but every year he's here. Last year he was very useful when we had an emergency. And he turns up here to look after us all when we have a bad turn. And that is our first aid man. And to present the award to him, I'd like to call up one of the great legends again, who's sitting around somewhere, the one and only Alan Sargent. Come on, Alan. No, that's Steve Gray.
No.
Where's Alan?
He's here back.
Well, he was here a minute ago.
He's done a runner.
He's done a runner. Coward. Okay, not to worry. We'll present it ourselves. Steve Cresswell, ladies and gentlemen, our first aid gentleman.
There we are, Steve.
That's our thank you to you for what you do for us every year. No money, just turns up. suited and booted and looks after us when we have our attacks.
Not too many attacks, please, please. I'll accept this on behalf of all workers, St John Ambulance workers. We're very busy at the moment over the Olympics, etc. And I'll accept this on everyone's behalf, working tirelessly up and down the country to hopefully keep you all safe and well. I'll give you the kiss of love later, Frank. Thanks a lot.
Only with tongues. I'm only joking. Ladies and gentlemen, is Tom Tyrone in the house still? Or is he propping the bar up? Right, not to worry. Right, well, I will start us off. We lost a wrestler, as you heard in the obituaries this year, so it's a posthumous one for us because we were going to do it before we lost him. And he was one of the great Dale Martin wrestlers, and then for some reason he fell out with them, as you do, and made his career as an independent opposition wrestler. But he was one of the most respected and liked wrestlers in his area. Everybody loved him. They all went to the funeral. And we want to offer him a posthumous award, if we may. And today we have his son with us, the son of the great Dave Hines. And he's a nephew of Butch Mason, the late Brian Mason. So can I ask Lee Hines to come up here and receive an award on behalf of his late father. Ladies and gentlemen, and Tom Tyrone, would you please come up and make the award for us? The one and only heavyweight star, Tom Tyrone. Thank you.
Not altered.
You don't need a box, you're so big.
I'm getting old now, I'm shrinking.
Yeah, you're all right.
Coming in.
Thank you. I don't know whether to accept this award on behalf of my dad or his hearing aids. he always said they got more heat than he did. Dave Hines, my dad, he wasn't famous, he wasn't a TV star, but as a child, going to countless shows through the years, he was my hero. He loved what he did, he loved the people we met, he loved the friends he made working in this industry. Many of them here today, many of them passed. When he retired in the year 2000 from wrestling, he used to enjoy coming to these annual reunions. He used to look forward to it. I always used to come with him. And it's a great thing. It's a great way to get all old friends together, and long may it continue. Thank you very much.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to introduce to you, if I can see him, a very special man. He used to be a wrestler, except that he wrestled in the Highland Games before he turned into acting. And he's now a true Hollywood legend. He's with us today because he wants to say a few words. And it also affects the next recipient. And he made, I suppose, 28 movies in his career for the House of Hammer. For 14 years, he was the Green Cross Code Man on television, and they say that he saved the lives of 65,000 children and was rewarded with an MBE for that. But of course, you will all know him as the one and only, the great Darth Vader out of Star Wars. Dave himself doesn't like to be known really for that. He prefers the Green Cross Code part of his life. He's still traveling the world. And I would like him to step up here, because I'm going to ask him to make an award to another wrestler. So please say hello to the one and only Dave Prowse, MBE. Is he there? Is he coming?
Crossing the road.
Slowly.
Someone's getting him over.
Well, while we're waiting, I can tell you the next award is for a wrestler who hasn't done anything in the recent years. He's been a prostate cancer sufferer, and he's also had bowel cancer, but he's recovered. He was a great heavyweight. He topped the bills many times in the early 60s, and He's come up to be with us today as a recovering person from cancer. Dave Prowse himself has had prostate cancer and is doing a national campaign to ask everyone to be tested regularly. And we all have these tests. I've just had them, and a bowel test. Bangor Walsh is having them. So could I ask, for, while we're waiting for the award to come up, Ray Luxford. Come, Ray. Ray was a great wrestler in the early 60s. I don't know where Dave's gone. So it looks like I'll have to present it, and he can say his few words afterwards. So, ladies and gentlemen, Ray Luxford, a Lifetime Achievement Award for wrestling in your early days, and congratulations that you've recovered from the cancer that you had.
Thanks very much. As I say, I think every man should have the prostate done.
Speak into it, Ray.
Every man should have the prostate blood done. It saved my life. Let's hope it saves lots of more. Thanks very much for this. And is that me? God almighty.
I'm round here.
It's ladies and gentlemen, it's Ray Luxford. Thank you. Thank you, Ray. And congratulations on your recovery. If Dave turns up in a minute, he can say a few words and we'll see what happens. Okay. Now, the next one, I'm going to call up next part of the Knight Dynasty to present this award to his friend. And so before I say any more, could I ask the one and only Rowdy Ricky Knight to join me on the podium? While Ricky's making his way round, ladies and gentlemen, we have a promoter with us today who made a big name for himself over the years. Very well liked, very well respected promoter. He now lives out in Thailand, where he runs a World of Sport restaurant in Pattaya, where he lives, where you're always welcome if you go over. Friends of mine have been, and they had a terrific reception. And I'm going to ask Ricky Knight to present an award to his friend, Scott Conway.
That was only the ladies' boys, wasn't it? Can I just say that I know Scott a few years now, and I work with Scott a lot, and we have become really good friends. And since he's been in Thailand, I really missed him. And he walked to me gym the other day. I hadn't seen the old boy for 9 years. That's really great to see him back, because I'll tell you something, British wrestling needs Scott Conway. Really miss him. So this is you, Scott. I think it's well deserved, buddy.
Okay, thanks a lot. It's great to be back in England. We've lived in Thailand for 9 years. It's great to see all the young faces and old faces back. And Jackie there. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Scott Conway. And don't you go away, Ricky, because it's your turn. The wonderful Ricky Knight, ladies and gentlemen. What a character this man is. He's built an empire up there in Norwich. Now he's a celebrity on TV. I need his autograph. We're going to give Ricky a Life Achievement Award, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm wondering, who have we got out there that's a TV star legend? Where's the great Bobby Barnes? Bobby, is he still here? Or is he propping the bar up? Bobby Barnes, ladies and gentlemen, coming through here. The bad boy himself, Mr. Bobby Barnes. Adrian Street's tag partner. Look at him. Looks 10 years younger than he is. Bob, would you please come and present an award to Rowdy Ricky Knight? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, it's nice to be here again. I try not to go home in an ambulance this time, but I got quite used to being here because you all gave me a really good boo. So, you know, if you could please repeat that today, it makes me feel better. Thank you very much. Those were the days. It's very... it's nice to have the opportunity to actually present this to someone that's still in the business, and I don't know him, but it's nice to think that wrestling is continuing, and that we've got people like this that are trying to make wrestling great again, because it has been a really great sport in the past, and I'd love to see that all happen again in the future. So I'm really pleased to be able to present Ricky Knight with this award.
Did
And
it's like I say, Bob, it's great to get the award from you, because you and Aidy, funny enough, growing up with my favourite Cambridge tag team, and I think me and Jimmy Ocean and Jimmy Zed would say we tried to model ourselves on you and Ada, and I think you're one of the best tag teams this country's ever seen, being a tag team special. Fantastic. And it's like I say, it's really humbling, you know. I come into business late in life, and you know, I was a bit of a tear away when I was younger, and wrestling has really helped me, and Jimmy Ocean got me into business. And over these years, I can honestly say, you know, I come to business, and before I come into this business, I was a rich man, and now I'm bloody skint, but hang on. But, you know, I've tried to keep the legacy going. I hope my family's keeping the legacy going. My sons and my daughter have been in America. She's signed with WWE and stuff. And I can honestly say, in the 27 years I've been in the job, I've met some really, really great people, okay? Friends all over the world. I just sent it when my son got married, just, you know, I just sent it his wedding. I'm in the wrestling business, and the wrestling is one big family. You can go anywhere in the world, you can find some food, and you can find a roof over your head. And I think that's the power of wrestling. I don't care if people knock this business, this is the best business in the world, people. Thank you very much.
Ricky Knight, ladies and gentlemen, and of course the evergreen, the wonderful Bobby Barnes. Ooh. What a great, great grafter that man was. Now, ladies and gentlemen, third part of that trilogy, standing over at the back to present the award, you will notice that they're not all pals and friends together. We mix and match them so that you can see that it brings the young together with the old, and everybody's a fraternity together here in the Ring of Friendship. So I'd like to ask another legend up. He's the nephew of the late, great Randolph Turpin, the boxer who beat Sugar Ray Robinson. Ladies and gentlemen, Jackie Turpin. Yay! I bring these people up so you can see them, you know who they are, you can mix with them, speak with them, and of course that makes the introductions for you. Thank you, Jackie. Jimmy
Ocean. Cheers, thank you very much indeed. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello.
What a lovely day, eh?
Yeah.
I was white when I came. You can't get weather like this in Leamington Spa. In the Midlands, it rains. Now, it gives me great pleasure to give this award to Mr. Jimmy Ocean. Come on, Jimmy.
Super flyweight.
Oh, super flyweight.
He was.
He was, yeah. Like a lot of us now, put on a bit of weight. Got a bit older. I'm only 36.
I thought he was only 20 round.
Jimmy Ocean.
I'm the only boxer to retire with a cauliflower arse. I'll have you know. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jimmy Ocean. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Like Vic said, it's a privilege to be a part of this big family. And all I want to say is thank you very much for having me, and thank you for a wonderful career. Thank you.
Yeah, give him a nice big round of applause.
Ladies and gentlemen, the superfly himself, Jimmy Ocean, and thank you to the great Jackie Turpin. It's like a who's who of wrestling year, isn't it? Okay, I see Dave Prowse, MBE, is with us in the house finally. So could I introduce him now just to say a few words? The one and only Darth Vader himself and the Green Cross Code Man, Mr. Dave Prowse. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dave. Thank you very much. Nice to be with you all again. Yeah, I come here every year. I'm a big fraud, really, because I only ever wrestled once in my life, and that was I wrestled a chap called Dennis Garvey, who was the Metropolitan Police champion, and he threw me around the ring like mad. I thought, thank you very much. That's the end of my wrestling career. I'll carry on with the heavyweight lifting. Thank you very much, and I carried on with it. I became the British heavyweight weightlifting champion, and I done all sorts of other things besides. You know. Anyway. It's lovely to be here. We always seem to kind of get the weather nice as well. I don't know how you do it, but we always seem to get nice weather for these dudes. And it's lovely for me because, as I said, I meet an interesting crowd of people, the sort of people I don't normally meet in my everyday life, because all I ever meet is Star Wars fans who want to come up and discuss Star Wars with me endlessly, and I'm getting sick and tired of wishing people, you know, may the force be with you, and I now tell them, I say, may the force be up you.
about
and that gets, gets rid of them. Sorry?
Sorry, I told them you might spend about getting tested for prostate cancer.
Oh, yes. Oh, sorry. I don't know whether you know, just recently, it was Prostate Cancer Awareness Month, and I myself had prostate cancer and got over it, fortunately. And they rang me up and they said, how would you like to become the figurehead of the Prostate Cancer Awareness Month? And I said, yeah, certainly, I'd love to. Anything I can do, anything I do to help the charity, I'm quite happy. I work with all sorts of different charities. I work with the Urology Foundation. I work with the, I'm one of the vice presidents of the Physically Handicapped and Able-Bodied Association. I work cancer with cancer awareness and things like this. But the cancer awareness, Prostate Cancer Awareness Week came up and they said, can we have some photographs of you, you see? So they sent me to a photographer up in London, and would you believe, in an hour, he took 230 pictures of my face. And they went up all over the backs of buses and in bus shelters and things like this. And they also did an arrangement with Marks and Spencer's, because Marks and Spencer's have a campaign, and it's called, well, at least their campaign is for Blue Harbour menswear. And when you talk to people about prostate cancer especially, everybody turns around to you, everybody says, well, you know, I never had any idea that I had prostate cancer, it just came out of the blue. And so this out of the blue thing became a sort of catchphrase for Cancer Awareness Month. And so, as I said, so if you went into the Marks and Spencers and around the menswear department, there was my picture out there as well, besides being on the backs of buses and everywhere else. So anyway, so if you have any inkling that you think you might have any problems prostate cancer wise, go and see your doctor. Go and get seen too. It's so simple to get sorted out, and it can be, if you leave it and forget all about it and think it's going to go away, it doesn't. You've got to get yourself sorted out, and it can be cured. It's curable. So please, as I said, if you've got any idea, get yourself seen too, by all means. It's been absolutely wonderful coming here again. It's been lovely. I'm travelling around the world. This next weekend I'm up in Liverpool. The following weekend I'm in Toronto. The following weekend I'm in Atlanta. And so it goes on. I'm sort of chasing everywhere with Star Wars. And we're getting huge, great crowds. I mean, you would never think that after 40 years, it's something I did 40 years ago, is so popular. I mean, it's we'll have something in the region of 100,000 people will turn up in Toronto, and we get probably 100,000 people turn up in Atlanta. You go to San Diego, and we get 150,000 people come through Atlanta. It's enormous, the popularity of Star Wars, and I'm only too pleased to be part of it. Anyway, it's been great being here for the afternoon. I hope you've all had a wonderful time. I've enjoyed myself. I'm sorry that I'm not walking very well, but as you probably all know, I had a big operation last year where I had my hip, my femur and my knee all replaced in one go. Unfortunately, it's not worked out all that successfully, because I've still got a very, very painful knee, and that's why I'm using this thing. But other than that, I'm perfectly all right. Okay, thank you very much. It's been lovely talking to you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the legendary actor, Dave Prowse, MBE. His next movie's RoboCop. All this metal. Thank you, Dave. We're very grateful to see you. Thank you. The true legend of the film world. He was voted the biggest movie villain of all time recently as Darth. Okay, back to our awards. We got 21 because we are 21. And so we're not ashamed of that. We're getting through them. We've got just a few. And then we're going to be treated to a real live cabaret act from one of the great bands, led by the wonderful Lloyd Ryan. So, now, is Steve Gray around, please? The former lightweight champion of the world. Can I ask him to step up? Is he there? Steve Gray? The one and only is Mr. Steve Gray. I'm going to ask him to present an award to cross the age barrier to one of the most up-and-coming young wrestlers today, who's made a big name for himself so far. And please welcome him, Yorgos Christopoulos, known as Yorgos. Thank you.
Come on, young man.
You can move quicker than...
Yes. One of the up-and-coming young men of the wrestling fraternity. I've seen him work. He's pretty good, actually. Have we got anything for him, Frank?
Yes, there beside
you. Oh, it's there. Thank you.
All right, they're all single.
Yorgos. Oh, I am.
Of course we are.
Yorgos. There you go, mate. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, it's a real honour to accept this award. Thank you to Frank.
John Ritchie, my trainers, and the guys that I've learnt from, Johnny Kidd, Steve Gray, Mal Sanders. It's a real honour. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yorgos.
No, it's all right. We like to surprise you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Yorgos, thank you. They're crossing the barriers between the old and the new, preserving the British traditions with a little modern thrown in, and of course the wonderful evergreen Steve Gray. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce yet another legend, and you all love him, you all know him. Come on, Kinky. The one and only Johnny Kincaid. He wants to present an award to a friend of his that's one of the great wrestlers of the 60s on the opposition circuits, and he will tell you all about it. Come on, John. Johnny Kincaid.
You okay, Lord? You all right?
Here you are. Yeah, I am now.
No.
No, I'm not going to fall, I'm not going to fall. Anyway.
Don't be doing that, don't be back.
This guy I'm going to give an award to, or the reunion is going to get an award to, right, is a chap I've met when I was working on the fairgrounds. I was boxing on the fairgrounds, and this funny fella decided to teach me to wrestle. I won't hurt you, he said. No, he didn't. But I've never been thrown for the air so many bloody times in such a short period, you know. Lovely guy. The first time I actually worked in a hall, he came around my house and he said, "We're short of one wrestler, you're coming in." I said, "I don't think so." He says, "You are." So I did. You see, I was on with him. And again, my arse never touched a bloody canvas so many times. I was up and down like a blue ass. Fly.
Yeah, we know what.
Right, yeah.
We know what.
Okay. Anyway, this guy, Johnny Monks, is now, was known then, as Johnny Hurley. So, John.
Come on, John.
Come on, boy. I don't know whether to love or hate this guy. Love him because he brought me into the game that gave me a good living and took me around the world a few times. Or hate him, because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have two new hips and a bloody new knee. Right, John. Pleasure.
Thank you.
Giving you
thank
that.
Thank you ever so much.
Jace, have you?
I would just like to say, I'm sorry to anyone who's ever worked with this man. It was my fault. Thank you, John.
So it was your thank fault, you. Was it?
Johnny Hurley, ladies and gentlemen. And, of course, the indomitable Johnny Kincaid. Thank you. Now I'm going to ask our Olympic champion here.
I've come south a lot in my career, but I've came on a few times. I come from a family of giants. My father was 6'4", professional wrestler, boxer, grandfather, street fighter, bare knuckle fighter. And I took after my mum. Yeah. So anyway, I had a good career, I enjoyed wrestling. I did the amateur wrestling, I did the show wrestling. Billy's over again this year to do his seminars on his street fighting and cage wrestling. So I'd just like, as it is now, to say that from the wrestling fraternity, I come from a long way, you know. And who's the thing I'm presenting to? The Mad Monk. Yeah, sorry. Yep. I've got that, okay. The Mad Monk. Mr. Brian Burgess. Where are you, Brian?
Brian, is he there?
There he is.
He's not old yet.
He's not. He doesn't look as mad as he used to do. Did he, Brian, eh?
Yeah, I've
done. Come up, Brian.
Hi, Brian.
You want a leg up or a leg over? Oh!
Stop it now.
Give me a pleasure to present you with this lovely award. I got one last year and it's hung up in my best place really? In my lounge. And who's that fella there? Yeah, that's you. Anyway, I'll give you the microphone and let you carry on from here. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much. I'd like to say thank you to all the wrestlers, because what has been said all the way through is we are a family and we've always got somewhere to go wherever we are in the world. Thank you very much.
Brian Burgess, ladies and gentlemen, the Mad Monk he wrestled as. Okay, we've got two more to bring us to our age. The next one, I want to introduce to you our president, the man who puts the reunion together for many, many years with Tony Scarlo. And I would like him to come up and say a few words, because this is a posthumous award to somebody he worked with very closely. Not one person, but three. And between the three of them, they brought more people into this business and are responsible for more television legends than anyone. So I'm going to ask you to say hello to our one and only Joe D'Orazio. He's 90 years old, Joe, and he's still supple. Yep, and he's still fit.
Fit
the drop. Look at that, he got on the box and he's 90. Joe D'Orazio, ladies and gentlemen.
Just talk into that bit
where
they won't hear you, Joe.
Right, I'm going to have a little chat now. This is about three people. But I'm adding another one.
Oh, you're a... He must be different.
Now, the Joyce brothers. I wrestled for many, many years with two of them. Great wrestlers, always crowd pleasers, all the usual stuff. But they were men that put a lot of stuff into wrestling. Into wrestling, and what I think made wrestling the golden years of wrestling. They are the Joyce brothers. Now, to begin with, there was Harry Joyce. Harry went off to Canada, ended up promoting, came back to England, started promoting again. And he had his two sons that became wrestlers. One was Ken Joyce, who also became a promoter later in life. And the other one was...
Doug.
What was it?
Doug.
Doug. I've wrestled them both and I've forgotten their names. Great, great family altogether. Now, well, the reason for me to read this out to you is because there was also another brother of the two wrestlers, and that was Ken, was it?
Steve
Joyce, and he came in here today to accept this from me on your behalf. It's a great, what can I say, a wonderful family, terrific business to get into, and wasn't easy all the time, but these two plodded on and on and on. And so I'm going to ask the remaining one, bear with me fumbling on like this, won't you?
Better than us, Joe.
Bear with me, and I'm inviting Steve Joyce to come up now and accept this from us. Steve, one thing I'd like to know, how did you get away?
I went and joined the army, it seemed easier.
Oh, that's good. I'm pleased. Take it home to the rest of your family that are alive today, give it to them, put it on the wall, let them look at it, talk about it for the rest of your lives. Okay?
Thanks very much, Joe. Well, as you probably just heard there, I escaped it all. Went off and joined the army at 15, which seemed a far easier life. Only because they told me they were going to start conscription in the 60s, but they lied. I'm Ken and Doug's half-brother. My dad was married twice, Harry. And they were up and wrestling when I was a young lad. So I really sort of didn't get to know much about it until my dad sort of started the promoting stuff and running around Northamptonshire, and he had his gym, one in Higham at one point, one in Earthlingborough. And there may be some guys here that have passed through, and if we have a talk later I may remember them, but I think I was 5'8" when I was 15 and joined the army, so they probably wouldn't recognise me now. But the legacy that Doug and Ken left me, followed me into the army. Every Saturday afternoon, young lads, 15, 16, up to 20 year old, after we'd done our drill bashing on the Saturday morning, TV room, Saturday afternoon, World of Sport, on would come the wrestling. And it seemed like every week to me there was either Ken, Doug or both of them tagging it together. But being a bit like a boarding school as it was, when they finished, They all want to have a go at me. I've got the broken nose and the tooth broken as well. So that was the legacy from that. But thanks very much. I accept it with pride. Thank you, Steve.
Steve Joyce, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the wonderful Joyce family, never to be forgotten, legendary stars. Now we've got the last award as such, top of the bill. And to present it, I want to ask a man worthy of giving that award, first of all, to step up here with me. There are many, many, many hundreds of legends. Each one's got his own character and his own favourites amongst you. But this man seems to be the most popular man of all wrestlers put together collectively. He is the man of a thousand holds. 10 times lightweight champion of the world. What else can I say about this man? It's Johnny Saint. John, I'd like you to present this because you're more than worthy of the person who's getting it, please.
Would you like to tell him about Sean or Charlie?
You tell him about Sean. Okay. For a man who's such a brilliant wrestler, he doesn't like saying too much. Ladies and gentlemen, the recipient of the award, we're very honoured to have him with us today. Through the 60s and 70s and 80s, he was probably one of the biggest heavyweight stars in Britain. He travelled Europe, he travelled America, he travelled Canada, before he settled in South Africa. As if that wasn't enough, he turned his gifts to writing, and he wrote about his own very sad upbringing, which was just for the family. But it was spotted and turned into a book that became a bestseller called Bless Me Father. He's now written another book, a follow-up, which will be out in the later months of the year, called The Donegal Drop, taken from his own favourite move. What else can I say about this man, the giant of wrestling? He's flown in from South Africa to be with us today. Would you please give the biggest welcome of the day to the one and only Sean Regan.
Come on, Sean, come on. Well, what more can I say, ladies and gentlemen, than what Frank has already said? But Sean, this gives me great pleasure to present this award to you. Okay? Thank you very much.
Johnny, thank you very much. I'm very honoured that somebody of your stature is giving it to me.
Flattery gets you everywhere. Be very careful what you say.
Suddenly I'm lost for words because I feel very, very emotional. Yeah, I've been planning to come here for years and years and years and years. And when I look down and see some of the guys that I suffered with, I look down and I see Colin Johnson. He and I were in South Africa and we suffered down there. I look down and I see the Dazzler down here. Many, many matches I had with the Dazzler. And you know what? This is one guy who could stand in the corner and nick the show. Joe didn't have to do anything. All the eyes were on. I see Joe DiRazio down here. So happy to see him. Man who refereed many, many matches of mine. And one day I said I was complaining about not making enough money. You know, there's no point in going up to the office to get it because we had the fiddler on the roof. Don't you remember him? So I said to Joe, I said, hey, Joe. And he said to me, Sean, you're not going to make any money until you start going abroad. And that's when I started going to Germany, to Kaiser. Then went off to Canada, went off to Japan 10 times. And it's been marvellous. And looking around and seeing all these wonderful guys. Yes, it's a family. See Harry Kendall over there, how many matches I had with him. A few of the boys there that, you know, now I'm a wreck. Every bone in my body's broken. I've got more scars on it than enough. All from you guys. Thank you very much. What you'd like to say now about the book, the next book that comes out, it's called The Donegal Drop. How did it get that name? I was in Canada, arrived in Canada. I got fired from my job as a teacher, as you know. They found out I was wrestling. That's why I got the name Sean Regan, okay? Arrived in Canada and they put me on TV and they said, what's your favourite hold? And I said, I couldn't think of anything else to say. I said, what's the Donegal Drop? That was the name of the book. It's all about the wrestling business, not knocking the business, but telling the story as it is, that you people, you men I'm looking at down there, and all those that have passed on, were really hard, hard men. You know, everybody gets the wrong idea about wrestling. Is it all bent? You know, I wish it was. And as Johnny Saint said to me, he said, if they asked me that question, I say it wasn't bent enough. You know, I mean, when you think what we went through in those hard old rings, sometimes you were lucky if you went to Ipswich, you got a bath. You went to Norwich, you washed in a bucket. We forget all that, guys.
Yeah.
We had some of the toughest, hardest men in this business, and it was just a wonderful, wonderful thing to know you. I'd just like to say one last thing for about Bill Bridges, my long time mate. Where he's hiding around the corner there. I'm going to tell you the story because it's in the book. I was wrestling in Aldershot, and it was decided that I should wear a mask as a zebra kid, not the second zebra kid, and, you know, to hide my identity, because I just got this fancy job in a school. So halfway through the match, there was a youngster called Neil Sanders, hadn't been long in the business, wanted to make a big impression, and the mask shifted round in my head. I couldn't see anything, I was blind as a bat. And Neil Sanders knocking the daylights out of me, so like all good villains, I went into the corner and kicked the ropes. I missed the ropes and kicked some bird in the face, and down she went. But broken jaw, broken nose, and what did I do? Well, I lost my bottle, I ran. Next thing I know, police arrive at my front door. Are you the zebra kid? No. Are you Sean Regan? No. Are you Jerry Murphy? Yeah. You're the same. You're the guy we're looking for. So I go to Bill Bridges and said, Bill, I've got a terrible problem now. The newspapers are on to me. I've been taken to court. I'm going to lose my job. And Bill, I mean, who would do this now? Bill turned around and said, tell him it was me, mate. Tell him it was me in the bonnet. So I did. That's when the coppers came round. I said, the guy you're looking for, his name's Bill Bridges, and he lives up in Eltham, up that way. You go find him, you know. Turns out Bill was wrestling in Littlehampton or someplace on the night I was in Aldershot. Police came back, said, right, we're going to nick you, you know, interfering with justice. We're going to nick Bridges because he's set himself up. A right performance. In the end, anyway, I got fired, and then I went off around the world. She's a youngster there, come all the way from Japan to be with us, eh?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Wonderful, eh? And that, just before I go, probably the last time I'll ever get here, I live in South Africa, I've invited Bill, I've invited Frank, I've invited Colin, I live in South Africa, any old guys who give me a hiding in the ring, you'll be very, very welcome to come and visit me. All right, I will look after you. Colin knows I will look after you, okay?
You looked after me.
Yeah. Okay, Lastly, without wanting to talk too much, I'd just like to say, Frank, thank you so much for this lovely thing. I will treasure it. I've got a few certificates at home. I'm a doctor, as you know, a doctor of philosophy. This, people, means more to me than the doctorate or the master's degree or anything else that I've got, because the wrestling business made me what I am. And I would like to thank you all for that. Thank you, Frank.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only world famous legend that he is, Sean Regan. Right, before we finish, in a moment we're going to have cabaret from a band called No Nonsense, featuring the great Lloyd Ryan on drums. Lloyd, as most of you will know, in the wrestling business was Kendo Nagasaki's manager for over 20 years. What a lot of people don't know is that he's one of the world's top drummers. He's played with Buddy Rich in the 70s. He's backed Cilla Black, Matt Munro, Johnny Ray, God knows how many more. He played with the Duke Ellington Orchestra. And in recent years, he travels with a jazz quartet. And this year, he formed a big band to bring back the big band sound and released an LP called Driving Force, which is absolutely fabulous and gets lots of plays on the radio because there's just nobody else doing it. Today we're honoured because he and his band, a four-piece band, are going to give us some rock music because it's a cheerful day. And so after I've said the next piece, I'm going to introduce Lloyd to you. And then the food will be obviously prepared in the buffet. We'll be around there in the marquee. And we hope you'll all come and partake of that. And if you haven't bought raffle tickets, please help us. We get no income for this at all. Only those raffle tickets. So please, we've got lots of prizes. Please put your hand in your pocket and help where you can. Now, where's Johnny Saint again? This is a bit special. Because we have no income, and because we're not beggars, but at the same time, we get asked a lot as a reunion. You know, and you deal with all the wrestlers through all the eras. So why do you not put on our British wrestling as we used to have it? Why do you not put on shows that we used to see and love, and we now have to go to men and movies to see what we love? We like modern, but we don't like it as much as the world of sport. It's our wrestling. Well, we say we can't have the following now. By the same token, we don't have any income, so we're just a charity. So Johnny Saint has been wrestling for 50 years of his life. He has been 10 times world champion. You don't get that title officially unless you are the best in the world at what you do. In his day, John probably wasn't any better than George Kidd or anyone else, but now, because he's the only one alive and can do what he can do, he is the best in the world. He's certainly the most popular. His videos and his DVDs are all over America, and all the American wrestlers learn from John, and they study him, and that is not an exaggeration. In 1995, John retired, said he'd had enough, and for 12 years he did nothing. But then we coaxed him out of retirement in 2007 in order to do a Legends show for us, which he did, against the one and only Johnny Kidd. That bout has gone down in the annals of wrestling as one of the greatest bouts of the last decade, which is a credit to a man of his years. Since then, John's been in such demand because the whole world thought, he's back, the great Johnny Saint. So they booked him, and since then, he's been to America, Japan, Italy, Germany, everywhere you name, they book him. Doesn't matter what he asks, they give it to him, just because they want to get in a ring with him. And that's the greatness of Johnny Saint. So we've already given him a reunion award, but today we have a special award for him, first of all, from the boy who travels from Tokyo every year just to shake his hand. So would you please say hello and say thank you to Shuey. Come, Shuey. Shuey Akora, ladies and gentlemen, from Tokyo. We would like to give John a special little award from him to John. Right, that's the first thing. Please, come on, don't be shy. Oh. Don't be shy. Look, he's with his hero. Ladies and gentlemen. Shuey.
Yes,
congratulations. Anyway,
thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. This is a real unexpected surprise.
And a pleasure. Thank you so much, everybody. And thank you, Shuey.
Oh, congratulations. Shuey Aoki, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, John. Now, it gets better and better. The answer to why we don't put shows on, well, we're going to. It's our 21st birthday and we're going to treat ourselves. And we're going to put on a show on February the 3rd at the Fairfield Halls. And there's going to be 10 bouts. And those bouts are going to include these following wrestlers. This will be the last bout Johnny Saint will ever do in his life. This is the last chance for any of you to see this man work in the ring before he hangs his boots up for the final time. And he, together with some of these other legends, will be appearing. Blondie Barrett, Johnny Kidd, Mal Sanders. Hang on, I've got the wrong bit of paper. I nearly read out Rain Bridges. Sorry. Gold Belt Maxine. Vince Randell will come out of retirement. John Ritchie. Mickey Shannon from Portsmouth coming out of retirement. Steve Gray. Keith Myatt, who's here today from Newcastle. Jackie Turpin will wrestle. Johnny Muscles England will wrestle. Ringo Rigby will wrestle. Paul Robinson, who's a young, absolute spot-on aerialist and world of sport wrestler, will do the warm-up with Marty Skirl, who was taught by us at Dropkicks, and John Ritchie, and has recently been starring in this Take Me Out program. Very well-known modern lad. They'll open up the evening. And the one and only Banger Walsh will wrestle. We will add to that, as we go along, two more bouts. That will give you 10 bouts. It's a matinee on February the 3rd, starting at 3 o'clock. All the details will be on our website, and we hope that you will support the wrestling in that way. Come along, get a ticket, have a family day out. There'll be legends galore turning up to be seconds, to join in. Wayne Bridges, Durazio, they'll be timekeepers. We're going to ask Bob Kirkwood to referee. Bob Anthony will referee. There will be a who's who of wrestling just for that one day only, in tribute to this man, Johnny Sain. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening. Thank you very much indeed.